Hi everyone and welcome to this new Toonmotion tutorial. In today's video, we'll be looking at the Sketchfab folder inside the Toonmotion library. The Sketchfab folder contains around 700,000 of assets created by the Sketchfab community. They are divided in many different subcategories as we can see here. Let's have a look at some of those. I will start by entering the Furniture and Home folder. The assets from the Sketchfab library are available on the cloud and available on demand. As you can imagine, 700,000 assets, it's a lot of data. And we don't want to have a crazy installation size for Toonmotion. So on some of those assets, there is a download button in the top right corner of their thumbnail, as we can see here. But the one at the top, I already download them locally in a past project, and I can reuse them whenever I want. For example, here, I can drag and drop that lounge chair inside my project. Or maybe that round carpet here. Those assets are created by the community from various CAD software, and sometimes unit might be a bit weird as we can see here. Here, I'm just going to switch to the scale tool and just scale that object to fit more my project. Something like that should work a bit better. As I said, those assets are available on the cloud, available on demand, and when you want an asset, you will simply need to mouse over it and come to the download button to download it locally on your machine. Right now, I'm not signed in on my Epic Games account, but if you are launching Toonmotion through the Epic Games launcher, this is done automatically. Otherwise, you can click on that login button at the top right corner of Toonmotion to sign in to your account. Now, the download button is available and you can click on an asset to download it locally on your machine. Once downloaded, you can simply drag and drop the object in your viewport. The first time you are adding that object to your project, there will be that small processing time converting the raw data in a Toonmotion file. And after that, you will be able to reuse that object by simply drag and dropping it inside your scene. The Sketchfab library contains really a huge variety in terms of assets. So here we had a look at some small props. There are even some photo scan interior of a museum. So here, let's try to download the dining room from the Old Wheel Museum. Just going to add that in the middle of my parking lot here. And let's move inside. So here, as you can see, we jump from an architectural building in Iceland in the middle of natural ground just to the interior of that museum in just a second. Let's have a look now at some other assets. I will come back in my library. Maybe we can enter the architecture folder and see what we have here. So it starts with some building, we have a basketball court, we have some shipping container. We can come a bit down here, we can find some neo-modular building, some more furniture and props. Let's now move into another area of our project and create something with some of those Sketchfab assets. First thing I want to do here is come to the Nature and Plant folder. Here I'm going to just drag that chopping truck. They're a bit too big with what I want to do, so I'm going to press Tab to switch to the Scale Gizmo and scale them down. Next thing I want to add is look for some tents. So I will come back in the Sketchfab folder and here type tent. So here, there are a few tents that are available. Some of those that I already used in a project, so I can drag and drop them straight into my project. I know that in the Toonmotion library, we have a nice fireplace. So I will come back here, I will move out of the Sketchfab folder, come to my object, Home, Backyard, Accessories, Here I can add those wood chunks to my project. And here I can also add that campfire. Finally, the last bit I want to add to this project is some particles. So we'll come here, particles, and add a small fire. So as you can see here, the Sketchfab library offers you a huge variety of assets to populate quickly any kind of environment you have in mind. Let's now say that I want to add maybe some wind turbine in the background. Let's come back in our Sketchfab folder, and here I'm going to type that. Let's drag and drop that first one here. As I said earlier, some of those assets can be out of scale, as we can see here. I'm going to come to the Scale tool and just scale down that asset. This feels a bit more right. One of the things with the Sketchfab asset that they come with a single mesh. As we can see over here, it's a single object and I can't detach the blades from the rest of the wind turbine. If I would like to do so, I will need to come to the Sketchfab website and download the asset from there. Let's actually try that. I will come to my library, and here I'm going to click on the Open in Sketchfab button that is going to open that exact object on the website. As you can see here, now I am on the Sketchfab website and I can download the asset manually from there. That object has been created by this creator here. And since all those assets are created by the community, when using those assets, you will need to credit the creator of those specific objects. Here you can click on Copy Credits. You can also do that directly within Twinmotion, and I will show you that just after. Here there are many different file formats. Twinmotion supports some of them, like the FBX or the GLTF. Let's download this one. Coming back to Twinmotion, I will come to my import doc, I will click on import, and I will load my file. My file has been loaded. What I want to do is make sure I've checked the Keep Hierarchy option that will keep the hierarchy set up in that specific file. Now that's done, we obviously have the same scaling issue. So I will open up my scene graph, and I will select the different parts of my wind turbine and scale them down. Now that's done, as we can see here, that specific mesh, the way it has been created, is actually divided in two parts. We have the blades that is detached from the rest of the wind turbine. So now what I can do is use maybe an animator, like a rotator, to bring some animation to that asset. Let's actually do that right away. I will come in my library, come to my tools, animators, rotator. I'm going to drag and drop that rotator roughly in the middle of the blades here. I'm going to turn it 90 degrees. I'm going to set already a few things, like here I want the animation to loop, I want the angle to be 360. And now I'm going to click on my tool to link the blades to the animator. And now it's playing that animation. Pretty easy. Actually, it's not rotating in the correct direction. So I will click back on my blade, select the rotator, and just turn it in the opposite direction, minus 360. Now that is done, I will select my folder. I'm just going to drag and drop the rotator and the blade inside the same folder. And now I can move that object exactly where I want. I can of course also duplicate that object. So here I'm going to place it a first time, and I'm going to duplicate it a couple of times. Here, the first one I downloaded directly from Twinmotion, I don't need it anymore, so I can delete that one. And as you can see here, that helps to add a few more animation to your project. A lot of the Sketchfab asset has been created as pack. So as you can see here, I've added those light poles and the highway stuff pack here. Again, when you add an object directly from the Twinmotion library, this is added as a single mesh. If you want to retrieve the hierarchy that you can see here with all the different objects separated from each other, you will need to come to the Sketchfab website, download the asset manually, like I just showed you, and you will need to manually re-import that object inside your scene. Let's actually do that one more time with those light poles here. I will come to my library, open in Sketchfab, and I'm going just to speed up the process. So here the light pole has just been imported. By default they are imported in the middle of the Twinmotion world, which is on our project here, so I just moved them over the parking lot. And now I can open the folder and check how they were made. I can also just click on the one I want, so for example here I want to select this one, and let's actually add some of those poles next to our road. Those items, now you can also save them in your user library to be able to use them in a future project. To do that, let's come back to our full pack here. I will click on the first asset. And this one, I'm going to right-click on it and click on Add to User Library. Now that object has been saved at the bottom of my user library, so if I come here, now we can see the light pole there. When you want to export and share an image that contains some of those Sketchfab assets, be sure to credit the creator of those assets. To easily export the credit line you will need to use, there is an option in the File menu, and here you can export the credits. This will create a CSV file where you will retrieve the name of the asset, the name of the creator, the type of license used. So here I exported my CSV on my desktop over here. There are multiple types of applications that can open a CSV file. Here I will start by opening it with Notepad++. You can also use a spreadsheet tool like Excel or Google Sheet for example. When you open that document, at the top, the first line indicates what you will see below. So it starts with the creator name. So the first part in all the following lane will always be the creator name. Then you have the asset name. So here we have tent. Then you have the license type. Here you have CC attribution. And then you have the download date. Here it's this one. And that's it for this video. Thank you everyone for watching it, and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone!